My brothers and sisters. Welcome, my brothers and sisters, to Our Lady of Guadalupe Catholic Church. We're very grateful to you for being here to pray with us for the funeral mass of Armando Sanchez. Let's begin our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. In the waters of baptism, Armando died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In baptism, Armando received the sign of the cross, and he now shared Christ's victory over sin and death. Amen. Now we will approach the altar of the Lord to offer the funeral mass for our brother Armando.
Thank you.
Sisters, as we gather in this most difficult situation, not only mourning and grieving the loss of our friend in Christ, Armando, but also battling the elements in this very cold and sleet-covered day, let's ask the Lord to give us the grace we need to offer this funeral mass with dignity and with total faith in the promise of eternal life. Let's approach our Lord in prayer as we pray. O God, who alone are able to give life after death, free your servant Armando from all sins, that he who believed in the resurrection of your Christ may, when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. You are Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now listen attentively to God's holy word from Scripture.
Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. And so the just man, though he die early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. He who pleased God was love. In a short while, he reaches the fullness of a long career, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he precious my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Even though I walk in the dark valley,
a reading from the letter of Paul to Titus. God has revealed his grace for the salvation of all people. That grace instructs us to give up ungodly living and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this world. As we wait for the blessed day we hope for, when the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ will appear. He gave himself for us to rescue us from all wickedness and to make us a pure people who belong to him alone and are eager to do good. When the kindness and love of God our Savior was revealed, he saved us. It was not because of any good deeds that we ourselves had done, but because of his own mercy that he saved us through the Holy Spirit, who gives us new birth and new life by washing us. God poured out the Holy Spirit abundantly on us through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that by his grace we might be put right with God and come into possession of the eternal life we hope for. Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, this is an unforgettable, very unusual funeral mass. I'm very grateful to you for being here with us today. On behalf of Anna, Gavin, and Devin, Frank and Maria, Edward, Danny, and Teresa, Mia, Colton, and Evie, and the entire Sanchez family, I would like to thank you for your presence here. here today for the funeral mass of our brother, Armando. It's a great tribute to your love and your respect for him that you're here, even in these very difficult conditions. Your prayers and your personal support are very much appreciated. In the upcoming weeks and months, I hope that you will continue to pray for the Sanchez family and love them and reach out to them with practical support as well. They need your help. And the most important reason why we're here today is to offer the sacrifice of the Eucharist for the repose of Armando's soul. There is no more powerful gift that we can give to Armando than to offer the Mass for him. The grace of the sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross is applied to Armando in this funeral Mass. And your prayers for him here today make a positive difference for his soul. Another reason for coming together for someone's funeral is to reminisce and cherish the memories. I encourage you in these days to remember your stories of Armando and tell them to one another and give thanks to God for the chance to share a bit in his life, the life of such an amazing Christian man. Remember his laugh, his smile, his big heart, his helpfulness, his knowledge of cars, the way he dressed so sharp. Remember his compassion for the poor. Remember his ability to become your friend immediately. And remember and honor the love that he had for Anna and his family, and his love for Jesus Christ, and his desire to save souls, and the way the room would just light up with joy when he would walk in. Death can take away your friend, but it cannot take away your memories. You cherish those memories. Another value in gathering for the funeral Mass is to be nourished by the Word of God and the message of our faith. In the 23rd Psalm that we sang in this Mass today, it reminds us that even though we sometimes walk in the valley of darkness, we can trust that God is here with us, right here, right now, to give us comfort and hope. In the first reading of this Mass, from the Book of Wisdom, it says that the death of the just person seemed like an affliction, like utter destruction, that they're at peace because their souls are in the hands of God. It says, the faithful shall abide with him in love. That's what awaits those who love God. And here at Our Lady of Guadalupe Church in Midland, Texas, you know what it means to love God. That's why you're here today in such numbers, everybody pitching in to allow this funeral Mass to take place because you love God. In the Gospel passage from John chapter 14, Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. Jesus has prepared a place for us that's waiting for us. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life that helps us to get there. And like St. Paul says in his letter to Titus, he says, God saved us, not because of any good deeds that we ourselves have done, but by his own mercy. It's God's mercy and grace that helped Armando to overcome some really hard times in his life. And God also wants to help you to overcome your hardships as well. So let God help you. Armando allowed God to help him. And you and I can do the same thing. Open our hearts to the mercy and grace of God. My brothers and sisters, we have been robbed. We have been robbed by this horribly destructive virus. and the death of Armando is a tremendous loss for our church, for this community, and for each one of us personally. This is unfair. It hurts. It's okay for us to feel shock, anger, sadness, confusion, whatever our feelings might be. We need to accept those feelings. And then we present our feelings to God and we ask the Lord, with the power of His grace, to transform our inner experiences into something that will give life. We ask God to transform our energy, our anger, into energy for good. To transform our hurt into warm compassion for those who suffer. We ask Him to transform our shock into vigilance to fight the spread of this virus. And to transform our loss into action to reach out to help others who are hurting too. We ask God by His grace to transform our pain today into redemptive suffering to help others who are hurting in union with the cross of Christ. And we ask God to fill the empty spot in our heart with His divine love. We open our hearts and we ask God to pour His love in to those empty spaces that are there by the loss and the absence of our friend Armando. Our Lord Jesus Christ made a huge impact in a brief number of years in His ministry here on earth 2,000 years ago, before He went up to heaven. And then, when Jesus went up to heaven, others stepped up to the plate to do their part. Armando Sanchez made a huge impact in our lives. And now he's gone to meet the Lord. And now it's up to you and me to step up to the plate and do our part. Whenever a team loses a star player or its coach, you can't just stick another person in there and replace them. It's not that simple. No one has the same exact package of talents or gifts or personal connection to you. However, anybody who believes in that team and the mission of that team will step up, put one foot in front of the other, and pick up the pieces and do their best to carry on his legacy. My friends, our time on this earth is very limited. We know that very concretely by the fact that so many of our friends and relatives have passed away these last few months. None of us knows how long we will be given to live in this world. That means each one of us needs to make the most with what we have been given. Life is a miracle. Life is a gift of God's amazing grace. And we celebrate the gift of life. And I encourage you to embrace the gift of your one unique life. And give thanks to God every day that you wake up breathing. And now you step up to the plate and you do your part and glorify God by the way you live every day. Now, my friends, we offer our prayers of intercession, remembering that God is with us, He's hearing our prayers, and let's place in His merciful hands the needs of all of those who are suffering.
In baptism, Armando received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now, and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Thus, who trusted in the Lord, now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Armando Sanchez, seek comfort and consolation. Heal your pain and dispel the darkness and doubts that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Armando. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We now will prepare the altar for the gift of the Eucharist.
Unworthy Lord, to come to you. Could you please come down to me?
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Almighty and merciful God, by means of these sacrificial offerings, wash away, we pray, in the blood of Christ, the sins of your departed servant Armando, and purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness those you once cleansed in the waters of baptism, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." God the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles, and glorious martyrs, with Saint Juan Diego, and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession, in your presence, we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, and Michael our Bishop, the other bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family we have summoned before you. Your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Armando, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Just by way of instruction to receive the body of Christ, because of the weather and because of health issues, the bishop has given us permission to go to you in your cars. So it's not necessary for you to get down from your vehicles. If you are receiving the body of Christ, please put on your hazard lights and we will know that we need to come to you. We have different ministers going out to different stations. And so if you just remain in your cars, and when the minister comes to you, just roll down your window and we will give you the body of Christ.
spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
let us pray. Having received the sacrament of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servant Armando, that cleansed by the paschal mysteries, he may glory in the gift of the resurrection to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Just a quick announcement that we do need to make. Well, first of all, and I know the family would like to express their thanksgiving for every one of you who are coming out in these conditions. It's a great honor, a good testament to who we honor today, our friend, our loved one, Armando. And so thank you for being here this morning. We need to announce that there will be no burial today. Armando and the family have decided that he will be cremated. Once the remains return, then we'll have an interment, a private ceremony with the family at some later date. So after this, the final blessing, after the commendation prayers have been said, and I'm going to ask you to follow the directions of the parking lot team, the members here, so that everybody gets out in an orderly fashion. Again, we want to thank you and thank especially our bishop for being here with us as we send forth our beloved Armando into the hands of God the Father.
My brothers and sisters, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We will now make our way to the casket for the song of farewell and the prayer of commendation.
Oh, Johnny,
take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, that perpetual life turn upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, O Father of mercies, we commend our brother Armando in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Armando in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. O merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask you this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, my brothers and sisters, for coming to be with us in this funeral mass. We now bless this cross. May it be a reminder of the life of our and the faith of our brother Armando Sanchez. May his family cherish this cross as a reminder of this holy occasion. You are Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, my brothers and sisters, for being with us here at Our Lady of Guadalupe Church. This concludes our funeral mass today. I hope that you will drive safely and keep the memories alive in your hearts of the example of our brother Armando. And let's never give up in our faith and our hope in eternal life. The Lord be with you.
And
the mighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Armando, God is good!
All the time!
God is good!
Amen!
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 Amen.
Amen.
Won't you know that I'm